Hey, heroes. Welcome to On Scene First. I'm your host, Tracy Eldridge. With over 25 years in public safety, I am wicked excited and honored to bring you entertaining, educational, and empowering conversations with public safety difference makers who are harnessing the power of out-of-the-box thinking when it comes to using the latest and greatest must-have technology tools, a people-first leadership approach, and mental health resources to save lives on both sides of the call. Before we get started, I would like to say thank you to our premier sponsor, NGA 911. With their reliable cloud-based end-to-end NG 911 solutions, I am super confident they can fulfill your needs when it comes to next-gen core services, call handling, data analytics, and much more. Oh, and did I mention it is affordable and customizable? Make sure you visit our friends at www.nga911.com and tell them Tracy sent you. Now, on with the show.
Got it.
All right. Welcome. Today, I am wicked excited for my guest. I'm going to let them introduce themselves in just a second, but I think that my listeners are going to be in for a big treat today, because while we're going to learn a lot of information like we normally do, it might be from a smaller version of what we're used to. So first, I just want to say thank you to my guest, Sergeant Isaac. How are you, Isaac?
Good.
Good. How old are you?
Eight.
And so my listeners, they can't see us. It looks like you're wearing a full-blown police uniform. Is that true?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Where did you get that uniform? Which department are you on?
NYPD.
NYPD. That's a big deal, right? So when I first met you, you were Officer Isaac, which means that recently you got promoted, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So mom or dad, either one, I'll let you guys go ahead and get started. If you want to introduce yourselves, and then I'll ask you a few questions, and then I'm gonna jump into asking Isaac some stuff. So
I'm Troy Pruitt. I'm Isaac's dad.
Okay.
My name's Lisa Pruitt. I'm Isaac's mom.
All right. Awesome. And so obviously this kid has gone viral. There is no question about it. And it is amazing. I will tell you, I'm going to tell you the first TikTok video I saw of you. You were pulling over one of the many vehicles that you pulled over, but Sergeant Isaac, you did something that a lot of people don't know that officers do. As they're pulling over a car and they're walking up to the vehicle, do you know what that is that I'm referring to? Huh?
Touch the back of the car.
Touch the back of the car. And when you touch that back of that car, I was blown away. Where did you learn about touching the back of the car?
On YouTube videos.
On YouTube videos. And for those of the folks that are listening that might not know the importance of why an officer will touch the back of a car, can you share that with them? Can you explain to them why that's important?
Yeah, so cops touch the back of the car so they can leave evidence to the last person that was on scene if anything happened to that officer.
Yeah, and we know, sadly, things are happening to our officers, so that's a way for them to protect themselves, right?
Yeah.
That was super cool. Mom or dad, jump in, either one of you. How old would you say Isaac was when he first started showing an interest in law enforcement? When I look back on some of the videos, he was pretty young, but where would you say that moment was that you knew he wanted to do something like this?
Probably about three. Yeah, when he went to the store and he saw a police car and just it went from there.
That was it. He was like, that's it. That's what I want to do. So Sergeant Isaac, I will tell you, just, you know, in full disclosure, I am a firefighter. So I'm hoping that that's okay. Is that okay? Do you love firefighters too?
Yeah.
All right, cool. And I'm an EMT too. But where I spend a lot of my time is working with the folks
in 911 in dispatch. So at what point did you start to see a shift where it just went from, because I know at one point, folks, when they're doing things on social media, it's like, oh, I'm going to upload this. It's fun. Where would you say the moment where you knew this was going to be bigger than what it, just posting videos as a mom? When did you see it kind of take off?
Well, when he just started playing around, I'm just staring, I'm watching him, and he's just, hey, mom, record this. And I'm like, all right, let's record it. But I was recording it, just not on TikTok. And then I'd go back into it, and then a couple hours later, he's playing again. He's like, mom, did you record it? Let me see what it looks like. So I'm like, all right, let's put this on TikTok. And then that started right from there.
And that was it. So Isaac, do you remember that time when you went to the store and saw the police costume and you said, that's what I want?
Oh, yeah, I remember.
You remember that now?
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
So is there anybody else in your family that is in law enforcement?
Yeah.
Who else is in your family is in law enforcement?
Uncle.
Yeah.
Yeah, my brother's a...
What was that?
My brother's an officer, a sergeant.
Yeah. So did he think it was super cool when you started showing that you wanted to be a police officer?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. You moved up in the ranks pretty quickly, right? So you started off as Officer Isaac. Where did you make the connection to the NYPD?
Yeah, Officer Brooke.
Yeah. So from what I understand from checking out some things, he reached out to you.
Is he your best friend?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Of course he is. He's super helpful when it comes to you being able to live your dream, right?
Oh, yeah.
So share a little bit about what he did for you that changed a lot for you. What are some of the cool things that he's done for you?
My favorite part about the New York part was probably going on patrol. And my first favorite part about the NYPD part was getting sworn in.
Isn't that really cool?
Yes, ma'am.
I bet mom and dad were super proud too, huh?
Oh, yes.
Definitely.
How important and how impressive is it that you're just 8 years old and you're already sworn in as the New York police officer? Did you get the day off on New Year's, or were they asking you to come in to work when the big ball dropped?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, tell her about next year with the ball dropping. What are we doing? What are Officer Glicks?
We're going over there.
Yeah.
No. Are you serious?
Yes, ma'am.
That is super cool. That's a really, really big deal. So when I was watching your TikToks and I saw that you went from Officer Isaac to Sergeant Isaac, folks that move up in rank that quickly must be doing something right. If there was a police officer listening to my podcast right now, and they wanted to move from an officer to being a sergeant, do you have any advice that you would give them on how to do that and how they should do that? Like,
what did you do to make it happen? Outstanding police work?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So outstanding police work is really important, right? So what do you think that looks like? What makes an officer an outstanding police officer? What do they do that makes them outstanding?
Practice and
helping
others and protect
others. And they have to be nice, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And helpful. And so there's a lot of times that you talk on the radio to your dispatcher. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
You take care of your dispatchers? Because I know there's going to be a lot of dispatchers that listen here. What can police officers do that's really nice to help take care of their dispatchers?
Talk nicely to them.
Very important.
Be nice to them.
Love it.
Get donuts.
Yes. Because you know what? The police officers and the firefighters and the EMTs, they often get all the cookies and the donuts and the thank you cards. And guess who often gets forgotten about?
The regular. The
dispatchers.
Oh, yeah.
You tell them where you left?
The Lower Paxton Police Department.
That's cool.
You just brought them 24 donuts?
Yeah.
Why? What's today?
National Law Enforcement.
Yes. When we, yeah. So when this when this record, so we're recording today, and then when it goes out onto the platform, will be past National Law Enforcement Day. But yes, today is National Law Enforcement Day, and we want to say thank you to all of our law enforcement folks and those that help out. What would you say your favorite part about being a police officer is? What do you like the best?
Helping people.
Helping people? That's a big deal. That's a big deal. So what grade are you in right now, Isaac?
Third grade.
So when you graduate from high school, are you going to want to go right to school for law enforcement, or what are you going to do there, bud?
Probably go right to law enforcement school.
Yeah. And I think that's super cool. So mom, dad, whoever wants to explain this, from what I saw, Sergeant Isaac has a dwarfism. Is that what he is diagnosed with officially?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So what does that mean for Isaac? Because what I'm seeing when I look at this is a smart, bright, brilliant, amazing, positive, happy child. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
So is that going to be able to help him be successful in this endeavor?
Yeah, I believe it will. I mean, that's what we started doing this for, is for dwarfism awareness.
So, yeah.
And, you know, showing people that, you know, this is his dream and we're going to do whatever we can to make that happen.
I agree 100%. And that's kind of why I wanted to, you know, have that information out there, because I do think it's important. And I know that you want to raise awareness for that. But I also know that folks may look at somebody who's different in any way and think maybe they can't do something. And Isaac, if there's somebody out there that wants to be a police officer, but they don't have that, you know, self-esteem to say, I can do whatever I put my mind to, what might you tell them?
Follow your dreams and never give up on your job.
Ah, I love that. And is that what you're going to do? You're going to follow your dreams?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So I know you have a sister too. Is that right?
Yes, ma'am.
How old is she?
Four.
So what does she think of all of this stuff with you and all this law enforcement stuff? And I'm going to talk about something cool that you did recently, but what is your sister? What's her name?
Gracelyn.
Yeah. And, I'm not sure I understand. Oh, and what does she think about all this stuff? Does she think you're crazy, or does she think it's cool?
She thinks it's very cool.
Yeah. So I saw on one of your videos that you got to take a really super cool ride not that long ago. Do you know what I'm referring to there?
Yes, I think in the helicopter.
Yeah, in the helicopter. Can you tell me about that? First of all, how did that even happen? How did you get into a helicopter?
Well,
it was a simulator.
Yeah, it was a simulator.
Yep. And then, so how did you get there? Is that one of your bestie officers' doings, or did somebody else help out with that?
Yes,
Officer
ma'am.
Glick. Officer Glick helped out with that.
Yeah, he helped you out with that. That's super cool. Where was that simulator?
In Brooklyn, New York.
Yeah, Brooklyn.
It was right in Brooklyn. And so I know you live in Pennsylvania, right?
Yes.
In Pennsylvania. So how long did it take you to get to New York?
About three hours.
Well, that's not bad. So you went to Brooklyn and you got to go into that simulator. What did you see when you were flying around the city in the simulator?
The Statue of Liberty. We almost we had to make an emergency landing on to a building.
Oh, you did? That's crazy. And was that super cool?
Very fun.
And you flew it yourself.
Mm-hmm.
What are some of the other really cool things that you've been able to do as a police officer?
Go on patrol and pull people over.
Yeah.
SWAT training.
Oh, that was very fun.
What was that? The SWAT training?
Yes, ma'am.
So I also saw, now this is something that's really important, especially with everything that's going on in the news right now with Damar Hamlin. Okay, so are you aware of what happened at the football game with Damar Hamlin?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. And you know that CPR And doing those types of things is really important. I saw recently that you were getting trained in that too. Is that correct?
That was with the Port Authority.
Yep.
So the Port Authority guys, they were showing you what it was like to help somebody that you come across that's not conscious and might need CPR. How did you feel about that training? Because it's really important, right?
It was very fun.
Yep. And you know that that type of help can really help somebody in an emergency, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's super cool. Do you have anything that you want to share with my listeners? Because the people that listen to my podcast are police officers, firefighters, EMTs, dispatchers. So anybody in public safety, is there anything you want to say to them?
Thank you for your service.
Aw, that's super cool. Well, thank you for your service too. Have you thought of going into the military or anything like that when you get older? Because I know a lot of times folks will go into the military and then do the police thing. Have you thought of anything like that or just go right for police?
Tell them about your brother.
My brother's in the Army.
He has a brother in the Army.
He does. What's his name? Yeah. What's his first name?
Andre.
Andre.
How old is Andre?
19.
19. So he's serving our country right now. Well, we got to give him a big thank you too, because anybody that is in service is really, really important.
Oh, yeah.
I also know that you have a post office box, and I want to make sure that if there's anyone out there, because what I see above your head right now is some challenge coins and I see some patches. So I have a lot of connections. And what I'm hoping is that you would share your PO box with me. And then that way, if anyone's listening, they are able to send you some of those things.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
PO Box 126709, Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, 17112.
All right. Awesome. So if anyone's listening and wants to share some love with our new friend, Sergeant Isaac, there is the post office box, and we would love to show him some love. So, and don't forget his little sister too, because we got to make sure that she gets some love too, right? So it looks like you might need a gold badge too. We gotta see how we can make that happen.
Yes, ma'am.
Because I think my sergeant had a gold badge. I'm not sure. I think he did though.
His on the hat.
Oh, yeah, I do have a gold badge on the hat.
Oh, you do? Okay, there is one on there. So you have the official police hat. And so I know that right now you're a sergeant on the New York Police Department. But when you grow up and you turn 18 and you can start looking for police departments, do you really want to go work in the city of New York, or do you think you want to be in a smaller area?
Yes, ma'am, New York.
You want to be in New York?
You're up for the challenge, aren't you?
I don't think I'd be up for the challenge. I give a lot of credit to those police officers in that city. They do a great job.
I wonder how many of them there is. Remember, Mr. Officer Click told you?
How many police officers are in New York?
36,000.
That is a wicked lot. So there's another thing that I wanted to talk about. You're not only an 8-year-old police officer, but you're also a music artist, aren't you?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell us a little bit about your song.
What's it called?
Goody Good Day.
Goody Good Day. So Goody Good Day. I listened to it. I love it. It made me happy. It made my heart happy. Where did that come from? How did all that happen?
I actually work with one of the producers on the song. Yep. And we just talked, and he knew about Isaac and wanted to, you know, collab with him and put out a song and have Isaac sing it. And we made it happen. And Goody Good Day's out, and we're finishing up another song. It's called Pray For You, and it should be out by the first of the month.
Oh, I cannot wait. And make sure that you let me know when it comes out, because I want to make sure that I share it on all of my social media.
We will.
Because I want to make sure that folks are listening. Is the song Pray For You, is it just for everybody, or is it specific for public safety, or tell me about that?
For everybody.
Good. Because we could all use some prayers, huh?
Yes,
yeah.
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, Isaac, I just want to say thank you so much for joining me. I think my listeners are going to have a wonderful time listening to you, and I hope that they send you some goodies. I know I'm going to send you some goodies now that I have your PO box. Okay. And is there anything else you want to say before we wrap it up?
To the law enforcement people that are watching right now, thank you for your service, and stay safe.
Oh, I love that. Thank you, Isaac. Thank you, Mom and Dad. Thanks for taking
the time.
Thank you.
I know that days are super busy, but sometimes we just need to have a feel-good story. And Isaac's story is a feel-good story about communities coming together and helping kids make their dreams come true. So I can't wait to see what you do in the next 10 years. And I'm going to keep following you, Isaac, because that day that you get pinned as a real police officer, I'm going to do everything I can to be right there cheering you on, okay?
Yes.
Yeah. Say thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right, my friend, you stay safe, both mom, dad, sister, brother, the whole Pruitt family.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hey, heroes. We hope you enjoyed the show. Please like and follow me on my On Scene First social media so you too can keep up with my shenanigans. And make sure you get to know our friends over at NGA 911. You can start by heading over to their social media and thanking them for being our premier sponsor. Remember, stay safe, stay strong, and stay here. We need you.